pretty good.
You're pretty good.
Pretty good.
How's it going, people? Finally, The Rock has... Okay, not The Rock, but finally we've managed to muster up some Metal Gear Online 3 gameplay and further online a bit of explanation. That's the online of Metal Gear Solid 5. Phantom Pain, for those of you that didn't know, it's not like a new game that's come out. Everyone's like, well, new Metal Gear Solid game already, but it doesn't have Solid in the title. Oh, what about Rising? That's not canon. La, 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 and all that stuff. Anyway, I shan't digress. We'll be talking about Metal Gear Online, and today we'll be paying specific attention to Bounty Hunter. That's one of the three game modes you can play. You've got Bounty Hunter, you have Cloak and Dagger, and you have Comms Control. Out of the three modes, I played Comms Control the most. Actually, I played Comms Control the whole day when it came out on Tuesday, and that was just a few days ago. And then once I get to like rank 17, because I was like, I want to be number one on the leaderboard, put me number one, please. Got to 17, I was like, you know what, let's try some of the other modes. They're there for a reason, and we've got a 2-week XP bonus, so it's not like we're not gonna ascend. See what I did there, for those of you that know I did, you know, prestige ascend. Anyway, yeah, we tried some of the 320s. I can't fault her, just like all of them equally. I cannot pick a favorite, and that doesn't usually happen. Like, if I don't play games like Call of Duty and stuff, but if I can compare it to a game that I've played before, I guess I can compare it to The Last of Us, being that Comms Control would sort of be like Interrogation, Bounty Hunter would be like Supply Raid, and Cloak and Dagger would be like Survivor, only that when you die, you don't come back to life. And anyone that's played with me always knows that when it comes to those game types, I'm always the first one to die. But not this time. I won't. Okay, I probably will a few times. But anywho, with regards to Bounty Hunter, you put on two teams, as you are in, put on two separate teams. Well, there are two teams that you'll put on, either Team Solid or Team Liquid. And you can have unique characters. They're usually given at random, unless it's a one-on-one situation where one person will be Solid if you're on Team Solid, obviously, and one person will be on Liquid if you're on Team Liquid. They come with their special perks and stuff, but we'll talk about the unique characters another time. Okay, the whole agenda of Bounty Hunters is each team has got a certain amount of tickets, depending on if you created the match yourself, how many tickets you chose, or depending on whatever the settings of the automatic match you searched for. Ah, the aim of it is to reduce the tickets to zero. Now you can do that by killing. That's how you do it. Just kill as many of the guys as you can, and that's basically it. It's basically just like kill fest. You kill the people, and then each kill you get, the enemy's tickets are reduced, and then you've got a bounty put on your head. So say if you kill 12 people, you've got a 12 bounty on your head. And there are two ways of reducing the bounty you've got in your head. I didn't even realize the second way until I actually started playing a bit more. I was just like, oh dude, that's nice. Okay, so the first way is you're getting Fulton away. Fulton being that, you know, that balloon that you see picks up the character. I love using the Fulton cannon, as you'll see in the second half of the video. It's really a difference maker in this game type anyway, Fulton cannon. Or, you know, you can have that Fulton punch, which is one of the unlockables for the infiltrator. I'll go through that on a different video where we discuss the infiltrator. So yeah, you can reduce your bounties by being Fulton. You do not want to be Fulton because that helps the enemy team out. So say if you've got a bounty of 15 on your head and the other team's got 5 tickets left, you get Fultoned away, and then your 15 on your bounty on your head will be added to the enemy team's tickets. That'll mean they'll have 20, and then your bounties reset. The second way is if you yourself Fulton someone. So say if someone has got a bounty on their head of 7, and you've got a bounty of, let's say, 8 on your head. You extract the guy that's got 7 on his head, and then you'll only have 1 bounty left, making you, people probably still extract you because, you know, every number makes a difference, but that's how that works. You don't want to be Fulton. Do you want to do the Fultoning? But, you know, when in the heat of the battle, the Fulton cannon, as I said, always acts as an advantage to the team that uses it properly. And to those people, those crazy guys, as you can see in this match, some people just go running like crazy. As you can see in the top left-hand corner, you can see if someone's running, because if you're crouching or walking, you don't show up on the enemy radar. If you run, they're gonna show up. People will proclaim as lag or whatever. Oh, how did you know I was there? Well, it's because you sprinted or because he saw you. That's simple matter of fact. I mean, that's basically it for the game mode. Kill, don't get faultened, faulting other people. And here's another thing that, you know, some people probably have already realized if you've played this, or if you haven't, stop doing it. When to say someone's got someone in a chokehold or someone's knocked out, some people are really tempted to just shoot the people. I'm just like, why? You could have interrogated him. That it was that one guy that had 7 bounties and you just killed him. So yeah, don't, if someone's knocked out, fault, I mean, if you're gonna do anything, steal the fault and then feel happy about yourself, then walk away. But yeah, always faulting. Don't kill unless you really have to. And if you see someone in a balloon, like one of your friends is in a balloon, because enemy team's always red, I think. Enemy team's always red from your perspective anyway. So shoot the balloon, because if you shoot them, they don't get faulted, and then their bounty doesn't get added to the other enemy's ticket count, increasing your chances of winning. Because I kid you not, I was playing one match, can't remember the exact score, but it was a difference maker. Like last 5 seconds of the match, I think someone had a bounty of 6 on their head. The enemy team had 2 tickets, we had 5. They extracted him, and then suddenly just changed the tides of battle. Suddenly they have 8, we have 5, and then literally one second, it was like, as soon as the tickets added, ting, and then we lost, and I was like, what? How? But? Why? What? Why didn't you shoot the balloon, guys? And then that was that was the end of the match. It was a good match, it was a close match, but that was the end of the match. Anywho, guys, I'll let you enjoy the rest of the video, and next one we'll probably talk about one of the other 2 game modes, but most likely we'll be talking about the Infiltrator, since we've got our character up to the max level of 37 for our first prestige. I know loads of people will probably be like, well, only first prestige, I've already got up to second or third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seven, and you know the rest of the numbers and all that. But yeah, of that lined up, and I hope you guys enjoy the video, and I'll see you on the next one. Enjoy and bye.
Eliminate or fortune the opposition.
On to glory!
Give me a hand. I should thank you.
Glory. On to glory.